A few years ago, I had a bright idea to make a giant light stick for light painting. This is back before I even knew what a pixel stick was, but this homemade light stick that I made came in handy with a bunch of different shoots that I was doing at the time. It's a pretty basic idea, but I figured I'd do a quick video on this just in case anybody else wanted to make one. It comes in handy, and it's really cheap. Also, this light is going to be bigger than the pixel stick. It can also be made smaller. Today, we're going to do a light stick that's 16 feet tall, which is pretty overkill, but it'll give us an entire wall of light if we want. The concept is pretty simple. We're basically going to be attaching an LED light strip to a pole, and you're only going to need a few simple items to make this thing happen. First of all, you're going to need some half-inch EMT. You could use different types of piping if you want, or some aluminum track, but we're going to use half-inch EMT. You can find it at pretty much any Home Depot or any hardware store. And with this, you're going to need a half-inch coupling. You're also going to need a 12-volt battery pack, and you're also going to need an LED light strip. There's a bunch of different types on Amazon, depending on what kind of features and lengths that you want. But today, we're going to be using strips made by a company called Govee. The Govee LEDs are all RGB and they're also individually controlled. Govee does have an app that you can use with your phone to get even more functions out of it. There's a music function, there's a couple different scene modes, and you can also control the light in individual zones, which can come in handy for light painting if you want different effects. It also includes a controller in case you don't want to use the phone app, but it's just nice that it has that extra feature. So let's get into this. We're going to do a full assembly and then we're going to talk a little bit about how to light paint and show you a few different ways that you can use this light.
Longer than a few minutes later.
Now that the primer has had some time to dry, we're gonna go ahead and stick the LED strip right to the poles. Because this is gonna be 16 foot long, we're just gonna assemble it first with the coupling. Our garage is like 24 feet deep or something, so we're gonna use a couple jack stands to support it. You don't have to do it that way, you can just put it on the ground. But my floor is really dirty and dusty, and it was windy, so there's extra dirt and dust and leaves, and you really don't want that getting under your LED strips. So yeah, let's assemble it and put the strip on. With the set screw coupling, all you're gonna need is a flathead screwdriver or a square tip screwdriver, and you just tighten these up and that's it. It's pretty easy to use these couplings. They also make compression style couplings. We went with the set screw because this is a little bit smoother and it's not gonna put a big lump in the middle of our light stick. Now we're ready to roll out our strip. It comes with adhesive on the back of it. Not sure if I mentioned it before, but this particular LED strip is not waterproof, so keep that in mind. But this adhesive does seem to be pretty decent, so this should stick on here pretty well, especially being that we put the primer down first. So if you want to make a shorter version of this, you can go ahead and do that by cutting along these lines. It gives you the option to make this thing as long or as short as you want. You don't have to make this thing 16 feet long. That's pretty big. It also makes it a lot harder to move when it's 16 foot and a lot harder to store. I'm gonna have this at the garage in a nice safe spot, but if you don't have 16 feet of room, you can cut this down to 8 feet, 6 feet, 5 feet, whatever you want. Just make sure that you cut along this line here, make it a nice clean cut. Also, when you're pressing these down, make sure you don't crush any of the lights or any of these little diodes or anything. Be extra safe about that kind of stuff, because one bad break on an LED strip and it'll ruin the whole thing. As for powering up our controller, we could use the included adapter if we just had something stationary, but we want this to be portable so we can take it to different dark places. So with that, we're gonna use our battery pack. This is gonna be a 12 volt DC source with all these AA batteries, and then you can put a connector on the end of this pack and then plug right into the controller. To do that, you can cut off the end of the adapter and then splice that onto this pack. But I already had one laying around because I've done this before with another 12 volt set of strips. So I already have this plug right here. Remember, black is going to be negative, red is going to be positive, and then we can plug that right into here and have power. As for supporting the battery packs, you can use Velcro or electrical tape and just tape it to the pole. It gives you a nice heavy base also, so it makes this thing a little more stable when you're actually doing your light painting. So you want to make sure that you put this on the bottom side of the pole, and then the top will be more lightweight, and it's a little bit easier to control it that way. Also, the correct way to do this might be to use some Stay-Cons or actually solder these wires on. But because I like having this battery supply for other lights and LED sources and car stuff, I'm just temporarily splicing mine on. This controller even has adhesive on the back of it if you want to use this to stick to the pole. So these lights are sound reactive. So right now, as I talk into this thing, it's gonna strobe through different colors and different intensities as I talk. These are actually really nice quality lights. Pretty happy with these, actually. I'm gonna go ahead and log into Epidemic Sound and try some sounds. So I wound up taping the battery pack to the lower part of the giant stick. I wound up just sticking a controller with the included 3M adhesive to the bottom also, and threw one tie wrap around the wiring just as an extra precaution. The controller has an on-off switch, and then two more switches. Like I said, it's got the built-in audio function. It looks like one of these is going to be like a mode button, and the other one's going to be like a color button. So you could do solid colors if you want, which is going to come in handy later. But we're gonna mess with this a little bit more when it gets dark out. Right now it's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So we're gonna wait till it gets dark out and then mess with this even more.
Approximately 10 hours later.
Light painting is done by setting your shutter speed on the camera to a very long setting and then using the light to paint the subject and or background as much as you'd like, or as little as you'd like. It's a pretty fun technique and allows for further creativity with your photography. In my area, it's really hard to find complete darkness, but the darker the area, the more effective the light painting is going to be. It's messy in here because I got 37 different projects going on at once, but we're gonna try to use the lights with the music function just to mess around with a way to use these for video. This whole idea was more of a photography thing, but I know that a lot of videographers might want to do this kind of thing too, so if we use this with the music function, it might make for some really good backdrop stuff. Not too sure, but we're gonna find out right now. Currently the pole is just resting on the fluorescent lights. We're gonna actually try to find some music and see what it looks like with using this as a background. Kind of wish I would have brought my fisheye so we could have got an even wider angle. But like I said, it's messy in here, and we're just doing this for something to mess around with, really. The mic with these lights is so sensitive that it actually picks up my voice also. You can see it's shaking just from hearing the diesel motor of my garage neighbor. Hi, Paul. And because I have allergies currently every time I cough, which is pretty cool. I mean, if you wanted to do some kind of like voiceover narration and have your voice actually affect the light. Now, there's a bunch of copyrighted music that I'd like to put over top of this, like Blinding Lights by The Weeknd and a bunch of Daft Punk. I'm in a Daft Punk mood. I miss those guys. There's a bunch of different ways that you can do this light strip idea. You don't have to use these particular lights. You can use whatever you want, really. Another great option would be to use some Type S lights. They make some really good products also. And all of Type S's lights seem to be waterproof. These lights are not. But either way, can't really go wrong with this idea. 16 foot is probably a little overkill for a light painting stick. It does make it harder to travel with. If you did Velcro, it would make it easier to break down and everything, but it's still pretty big. But it is a pretty good, cheap alternative to the Pixel stick and some of the other options that are out there. If you're looking for something cheap and easy to use that isn't your cell phone or some sort of expensive light on Amazon, you could just do this and come up with some pretty cool stuff if you want it. So I think we're gonna end the video here. I'm very tired. I'm really sleepy. It's been a long day. We've been working on this project and a couple other ones. So I really like this light strip. It's pretty cool. And I think we're gonna use this light stick on a lot of photo ideas and video ideas. And if you would be so kind, maybe consider liking and subscribing. We got some other car projects coming up and some videography projects and some LED stuff coming up soon. So stay tuned for all that. It should be pretty cool. If you'd like to purchase any of the products used in today's video, there will be links in the description below. But yeah, thanks for watching and hanging out, and I will see you soon.